Hello everyone, welcome to a sing-along. We're all putting up with this COVID, and the way I pictured this whole thing happening would be if there were a whole group of people here singing along with me. So we're going to have to make do, and I'm going to have to ask you to pretend that you're in a large group and you feel comfortable singing even if you're all by yourself at home. And if you're with two or three other people, talk to them, tell them you're going to be singing for the next hour or so, because this is a sing-along for you. I'm going to take us through a few years of music, and we'll go through several decades, because I don't know who all is out there watching this today, and many of us grew up in different decades with different music that was close to our hearts. So I'm going to start with a song that is older than anybody watching out there today. It's a very old song that we all must have learned from a grandfather or a grandmother or a mother or a father. And I'm just going to play it on the guitar and you're going to know what it is, and then we can sing it together. You will know the words too, and it's again way back 1872 was when the melody for this was written. And the guy that wrote this has a great name. His name was Brewster Higley. He sounds like a real character to me. But Brewster Higley and Daniel Kelly worked together and wrote this song that we all know. Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day.
Da da da. those things you can bet your life it isn't hers. Could she love? Could she woo? Could she, could she, could she care? Has anybody seen my gal? Has anybody seen my gal?
Participate. Like I said, this is a sing-along, and we've got to generate the energy for this thing all within our own within our own homes. If you're in the kitchen or the living room, dining room, wherever, if you got some other people that can come and join you, great. And if there's nobody else around, that's great too. This is one of my favorites, and we're moving now into. Anybody Seen My Gal was 1914, and now we're going to move to 1927 with one that I think a lot of people will know as well. Managed to get this song turned into the state song, the kind of the national song, or whatever you would call it for the state. Like, and so he might have had a little bit of a self-serving interest there, but side by side is the You Are My Sunshine is the song that it became the state song, and I think we all know. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You may be happy when the skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamt I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken, and I hung my head and I cried. Hey, harmonies, you are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when the skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Please don't take my sunshine away. All right, I think we all know that one. Now this one is, I'm going to go back to 1928 for this one. And this is one that I played in a few residences around in the province over the last little while. And not everybody knows this one, but it comes from 1928. And it's just a real sweet little song. It's very short. And I'd be curious as to whether how many people know this. I don't know if there'd be a way that you could communicate that back to us. I'll have to ask people here at Macaw, who are doing such a great job of putting this concert on, if there's a way that you can let us know what you're, I'm getting some nods, so there will be a way that you can let us know whether you know a song or two that we do here. This one's called I'm In Love With You, Honey. I'm in love with you, honey. Say you love me too, honey. Nobody but you, honey. Seems funny, but it's true. Loved you from the start, honey. Bless your little heart, honey. Everything will go more sunny, honey, with you. Let's do an instrument.
Seems funny, but it's true.
Loved you from the start,
honey. Bless your little heart, honey.
Everything. I don't know if you know that one. I think it was recorded by Rudy Valley. So you can just, if you know what Rudy Valley's voice was like, you can hear him doing that in that high, high tenor voice. And it's a beautiful melody, another one of those that's just a very, very pleasing little ditty. So, we're going to move into the 1930s, and this is a fun song written by a guy named Billy Hill in 1936. And I think you might remember this. It's called The Glory of Love. You've got to give a little, take a little, let your poor heart break a little. That's the story of, that's the glory of love. You've got to laugh a little, cry a little, let the clouds roll by a little. That's the story of, that's the glory of love. As long as there's this, the two of us, the world in its charms. When the world is through with us, we'll be safe in each other's arms. You've got to win a little, lose a little. You can always have the blues a little. That's the story of, that's the glory of love.
We could find us a brand new recipe. on, have fun, come along with me. I'm free and ready, so we can go steady, cause the keeping steady come from me.
I'm dreaming.
do a fade out at the end of that one. That was a common way to end the song back in the 50s. I hope you had some harmonies with that, because that's the beautiful Everly Brothers harmony. I'm sure somebody out there was doing that other harmony part, because it's really such a beautiful song. So if we move into the early 60s, in the late 50s this was happening too, but of course there was a fellow that came along that changed music quite a lot. I say quite a lot because Elvis Presley, they call the king of rock and roll, but he didn't originate it. There were fellows like Chuck Berry and Carl Perkins who were out there doing that style of music, and Elvis was just the guy that really popularized a lot of things. But oddly enough, the song I'm going to sing today isn't one of the rock and roll songs. It's a beautiful, beautiful ballad. And as we've been going through the years here, we're up to 1961. But the melody for this song is actually the oldest melody that we've had yet today, because the melody for this is dated back to 1784, and it's an old French folk song called Plaisir d'amour. And the song Can't Help Falling in Love with You was based on that traditional song. But it's a beautiful tune that's been sung over and over and over the years. And again, this is a song for me that I just started to recognize more recently, because Elvis Presley was just a little bit before my time, a little bit. And so I didn't listen to much Elvis Presley music, but this is a really beautiful song that he popularized.
Falling in love with you.
Leslie. So we're in the 50s, and before we leave the 50s, now we're getting into some of the performers that bridged over the 50s and the 60s, and I can remember in my family, we started to have teenagers in the house in the 60s, and of course, that's when a big musical revolution started with the Beatles and the Rolling Stones and all those kinds of bands. And so, of course, that music was in our house, kind of much to the chagrin of my mother, who was really into classical types of music. But there was a performer who was doing a lot of music that in those days they called it international music, and it was simply because it was other cultures were starting to have their music come into North American music, and a fellow named Harry Belafonte, who had Jamaican heritage, started to become very popular. And Harry Belafonte was music, he did a lot of music that my parents liked, and the teenagers, us kids in the house, liked it as well. So it was, he was a performer who kind of bridged the gap between some of the new rock and roll that was going on and some of the other styles of music, because everybody seemed to like Harry Belafonte. And one of his most popular songs has become a standard around campfires and anytime there's a sing-along. I've sung this song for years, and then I didn't sing it for quite a number of years because I just wasn't around campfires and that kind of thing. And when I kind of picked up this song again, I just realized why it's become such a part of our culture. It's because it's just such a great song. It's such a beautiful song. It's nicely written. It's got beautiful rhymes. It was written by Irving Berge and popularized by Harry Belafonte. Jamaica Farewell. Oh, get your maracas going with this.
Many a day.
So, let's do one that everybody knows. And this one, I'm going to skip way, way back to the oldest melody in the entire set. And this is one that you all know. And it, apparently, I mean, some of these songs, they have to go researching to figure out where they came from. But this probably came out of Scotland. And it's got a date that I researched, about 1746. My Body Lies Over the Ocean. And we all know this one. So let's just sing it through once. But just take a note of what a beautiful melody this, is. We've been singing it for so many years, and you don't always stop to just kind of focus on what a beautiful melody some of these songs are. So let's sing My Body Lies Over the Ocean, then we'll have some fun with it. My body lies over the ocean. My body lies over the sea. My body lies over the ocean. Oh, bring back my body. And that's what musicians tend to do. So if you haven't been participating, then we're getting near to the end. So come on, let's crank it up a bit here. So let's have some fun with My Body Lies Over the Ocean. Depending on whether you want a little exercise or not, or whether you just want to take it easy, I'm going to ask you, we're going to sing this again, and every time we sing a song that begins with the letter B, you can stand up or put your arm up in the air. And then hold it there until we come to another word that begins with the letter B, and then you can bring it down again. Now, if you want to get a good workout, then stand up on the letter B and sit down on the next letter B and keep doing that. And we'll have some fun with this. Now, I can't play the guitar and lead this and do it all at the same time, but I'll do it a little bit just to get you started. So, can't be that hard. My body lies over the ocean. I think you got it up. My body lies over the sea. Okay, ready to go up again. My body lies over. If you think about it,
there are quite a few that are out there that people use to say goodbye. So I thought we'd have a long goodbye today. We'll kind of be like one of those families. I don't know if you've ever experienced. It's always your in-laws where when it's time to leave, everybody stands around the door and it takes forever to get everybody out the door because Aunt so-and-so wants to just chat about one more thing. And some families are like that. It takes forever to say goodbye. So we're going to take our time with goodbye too, and we'll sing two or three, maybe three or four goodbye songs. So one that I've just kind of rediscovered is one that I hope you know, and I think you will. It's Till We Meet Again, or it's also known as Smile A While. And this goes back, now we're going back again in time, 1918. So that's one farewell song. There's another one that I've got here that I won't sing all the verses to this, but a lot of these farewell songs kind of have a sway back and forth feel to them. Long time since I've been home, and I've got to be drifting along. So,
just do the chorus together. Now, if you haven't been singing, this is your chance. We're getting near the end, so here we go. So long, it's been good to know you. So long, it's been good to know you. So long, it's been good to know you. What a long time since I've been home. And I've got to be drinking along. I've sung this song and I'll sing it again. Of the people I've met and the places I've seen. Some of the troubles that bother my mind. And a lot of good people that I left behind. Singing so long, it's been good to know you. So long, it's been good to know you. So long, it's been good to know you. It's been a long time since I've been home. Another farewell song. We'll do two more. One that I doubt you will know. This is one that was written in 1988 by Tom Chapin. And this is a very beautiful farewell song. And if you've got anybody beside you there right now, this is definitely a sway back and forth, lock your arms kind of a song. So it's called Together Tomorrow. And I'll teach you a little bit of the chorus, and I think you'll get the hang of it. Okay, I almost made it through a whole hour without a drink of water. I think that was a good idea. So, it's called Together Tomorrow.
Together tomorrow again. Together.
day, but because yesterday was Remembrance Day, we're going to close with a song that was sung back around the Second World War time. And I think we always start to hear a few Vera Lynn songs around the time of Remembrance Day. And she has that beautiful song, We'll Meet Again. So let's finish off with that one today. And we've had our lengthy goodbye. I really want to thank everyone here at Macaw for putting this on. This is just a wonderful thing, and this organization is just getting started at doing a lot of wonderful things in the Manotick area. And so thank you so much to Catherine and Fraser McBee and Kurt and John Julian and Liz. Those are the folks that I know so far at Macaw, because we've just started to get to know each other. But let's finish off with We'll Meet Again. This might have been playing fairly recently, because Vera Lynn and a lot of her songs were a big part of World War II.
They'll be happy to